Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to part 3 of the Red Tent Restoration Series. In this video, I want to do some cleaning. I basically want to clean every piece of metal, every piece of chrome, basically anything that I'm not going to be taking to the powder coating shop to have powder coated and sandblasted. So I'm going to start with actually the isolation slash transformer power brick block, whatever you want to call it. This thing is just gross. I mean, there's all kinds of grime and dirt, dust. It's just gross. And although I'm not going to see this, I want to clean it up because it should be cleaned anyways. You don't want, you know, really corroded, dirty parts, especially when you're dealing with like the power, something really, really vital. And so I'm not concerned about making it look pretty. I just am more concerned with getting rid of all the grease and grime and ugly stuff, so to speak, that could cause harm to it. So I am going to go grab some tools and cleaners and basically everything I need to get going on this thing, and I'll be right back. Okay, I think I've got everything I need here, at least to get started. What did I grab? I grabbed a paintbrush, which I find extremely useful, stuff like this where there's a lot of nooks and crannies, a lot of dust, and I don't have to worry about it being too damaging to the device. It's a pretty soft brush, so I can get in and get all the dust out without worrying about damaging the power supply. So, paintbrush. I also grabbed some Simple Green, very good for just all around general cleaner. And then I also grabbed a rag that I'll use with the Simple Green. And then I grabbed some, 000 steel wool. I think this should work fairly well for cleaning up any of the really tough grime and whatnot without being too fierce. So I think that's everything I need to get started. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the paintbrush and just see if I can get any of this this dirt and dust off here before I move to the other tools. So I'm just going to start down here, and I can already see that it's picking up some of the dirt, so that's good. Anything I can get off with this brush is a bonus, because it's really easy to use. Holy smokes, there's a lot over here. Just gonna kind of give it a once over. Again, I'm not real worried about making this thing look brand spanking new and sparkly, because truth be told, no one's gonna see this. I just want it to work well and be kind of future proof. So that's all I'm concerned with, and why I'm going after this grime and dust, because all this stuff, you know, rust is always bad and oxidation, but dust especially is really bad when it comes to stuff like this, because it basically functions as an insulator and can cause stuff to short, overheat. If you know, it's just like no different than like with computer parts. You know, you get stuff that's caked with dust and pretty soon things are shutting off and overheating. So, and it can be a fire hazard too. Okay, well, I don't think I'm gonna really get a whole lot more out of this. So, you know, this did a pretty good job. I don't know how well it shows up on the camera, but you know, I'm pretty pleased with what this did tackle. I can see my paper towel here getting dirty, so that's a good sign. Next, I'm gonna go over this with some Simple Green. I'm just gonna spray a little bit on my rag here, because I don't really wanna spray directly on this. I don't wanna risk getting the internal electronics damp. And from what I've heard, that liquid in general with these transformers is never a really good thing. So you have to be kind of careful. So I'm just going to spray a little bit on my rig here. And let's see. I'll start down here. And there's definitely some rust on this, and I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with that. You know, the steel wool or maybe some sandpaper would probably take care of that. I think I need some more simple green. Oh wow, that's really doing wonders. I don't know if you can see that, but this is really taking off a lot of this grime on top here. It's almost night and day. Wow, okay. It's kind of tough to get in these little tiny nooks. But again, I'm not going for perfection here, but just a good once over. Wow, this is working really well on this part. Yeah, I mean, you can see how much it's taken off. All right, I'm gonna keep moving on here. Yeah, it's not really doing a whole lot down on the base here. And I think that's mostly because this is, the majority of this is rust. So I keep moving on. Yeah, this is really exciting, isn't it? Cleaning metal parts, yeah. Definitely not the most glamorous part of this restoration, and by no means my favorite, but it's got to be done. Okay. Oh yeah, it's really taking everything off. It's working. This stuff works really well. Just a little bit of elbow grease goes a long ways when it comes to this cleaning. All right. Holy cow, I mean, look at that. It's kind of the indicator if you're making progress. How dirty is your rig? That's not always true, I guess, but it works for me. Okay. All right, I think I'm gonna try a little bit of the steel wool now. I mean, I'm actually pretty happy with where this is, but I wanna see if I can get any more of this kind of light rust / oxidation. Actually, before I do that, I see some dirt on the inside in here. And try to get that out. Might actually need to use my rig here. Yeah. Actually, I don't even know how I can get. I suppose I could take this off. You know, I think I'm going to grab like a flathead screwdriver, something that I can actually take my rig and get on the inside there with. So hang on one second. Yeah, this should work. All right, let's try this. I'm gonna spray a little bit more on my rig here. And do something like this, see if I can get in there. Oh yeah, that's working. Ooh, look at Ick. Look at that. All right, well, keep going at it here. I'm gonna go around this side too. That's pretty good, actually. I got most of it. You know, if I was really gonna go all out, I would probably take this piece off. But again, I'm not too concerned about getting this thing to look like it just came out of the factory. I just want it to be clean and not necessarily presentable, but functional. So from there, I think I'm gonna go with some of this steel wool, just kind of do a once over and see if this will take anything else off that I may have missed already. Let's see here, unravel a bit of it. And actually, I wonder, I might try this with a little bit of Simple Green. I don't know, it's an experiment. I don't really use steel wool a whole lot, so for all I know, this is a crime. But let's see here. Oh, that's working quite well, actually. Simple Green and steel wool. Who knew? And I know you can't see this part right now. I'll show you, but it is taking off another thin layer of grime and I think some of the oxidation, if I'm pronouncing that right. I'm just kind of going over everything with this, even these wires, because wires are dirty too. I know some people will take this whole thing apart. They'll take piece by piece and they'll make it look brand new. They'll repaint it, and that's not really my style. I'm not concerned with the internal components looking brand spanking new. And I guess some of the purists would call that, not a full restoration. But you know, as long as everything's clean inside and it works well, you know, I could really care less how it looks. It's the outside that I care about looking brand spanking new, and that's I think how a lot of people feel. Maybe not. Maybe I'm in the minority. Okay. This is looking pretty good. It really cleaned up this top piece here. I don't know if you can see it. Let me hold it up here. Let's see here. So this piece here, I couldn't even read these numbers before. That's how much of a difference a little cleaning goes. So pretty remarkable. And And I got a little bit more to do, and then should be all set to go. Let's see here. All right. Almost done here, finishing up, and I think I'll be done with this. All right, let me actually, no, I'll use my rag here. Okay, just gonna find a dry part of my rag and just kind of wipe this down. I'll probably actually set this in front of a fan just to make sure that everything is completely dry. Okay, I think I'm done here. Let's see if you can see this here. Let me just focus. But, you know, it's not perfect, obviously, but I would say this is about 10 times better than what it was at. You know, this was really gross. So was this top area here. Like I said, I couldn't even read these numbers. So, I mean, overall, pretty happy. I think this is, this transformer / isolation transformer is, I think it's all done. I think we're ready to go. So I'm going to stop here, and then I want to move on to the other metal parts. So give me a second. I'll be right back. Okay, next thing I want to work on is the metal base, the two stainless steel bases that basically hold the game up. And let's see here if this shows up here. They're really rusty, and I want to get rid of all that rust if I can. But before I do that, they're really grimy and dirty, and you can see all this grime, dirt, and buildup that's on here. And so before I can tackle that rust, I need to clean each of these parts. And here, let me show you this other one. This one's a little more noticeable. Let's see here. So yeah, you can see all this rust. It's not really thick, but it's bad enough that I want to get rid of it so that I can polish this up and make it look a bit more presentable. And if you look at here, the bottom is absolutely terrible. It's just filthy, grimy. There's all kinds of dirt completely along this base. And so I think I'm going to start by cleaning that, and then I've got something that'll handle that rust, I think. I've never tried it before. So anyways, I'm going to start by cleaning this. Okay. I'm actually in our kitchen because don't have a lot of options when you're in an apartment. But anyways, I've got this stuff here. It's called Greased Lightning, and this is basically just a degreaser and a cleaner. And I do have some other stuff like Goof Off, and although I think that would work the same, it's, you know, it's a bit more pricey, and this stuff I've got a lot more of, and I think it'll accomplish the same thing. You know, it's basically just to get rid of all that grime and dirt. So I'm gonna try this first. If I need to go with something heavier, I can do that. All right, I think I'm just gonna pour some of this stuff on my, this is basically a Scotch-Brite pad, and this is supposedly their non-scratch variety. And I was gonna go with something a little bit harsher, but I really don't wanna scratch this stuff up any more than it already is. So I'm gonna try this pad. And I also have that steel wool, but I think this will do the job just fine. So I'm just going to pour some of this on my pad here. I'm using this tub just to catch any of the excess. So I'm just going to start, let's see if I'm just going to start by rubbing this, and that's actually doing a pretty good job already. Hopefully this shows up well enough on the camera. Okay, well, that looks pretty good. You know, now that's all that's remaining is the rust, which is what I want. Well, I don't want the rust, but at this point, I want everything gone but the rust. So I think I'm gonna grab a paper towel just to wipe this off. Doesn't have to be completely dry because I'm going to be soaking this in another liquid. Yeah, much better. I would say that's a success. Now let's move on to the other two pieces I've got here. Okay, well, I cleaned out, well, actually washed out the plastic container here. So we're ready to start soaking the parts in metal rescue. And actually, let me show you. So it's this stuff. This is, I guess, the Menards brand of EvapoRest. But this is 1 gallon, and you're supposed to soak the parts in the stuff. It says, you know, light rust up to 2 hours, moderate rust up to 8, heavy rust up to 24 hours, or until rust is removed. I would consider the rust to be light to moderate on these parts. And I actually bought 2 gallons of this stuff because I need a fair amount in order to get all these parts to fit inside here. And 1 gallon only is maybe, I don't know, maybe up to like here. And so I bought enough where I think I'll be able to get them half submerged. I don't have enough to submerge them. I will need to buy like 4 gallons of this stuff. And it's like, you know, $20 a pop. So not too cheap.
So I figure what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put all these parts in here like so, and submerge them halfways, let it sit for, I don't know, I was thinking at least like 4 hours. And then when that time's up, I'll just flip them over and get the other side. And the cool thing about this stuff is apparently you can reuse it. So it doesn't really run out of juice. It does, but it takes a long time from what I understand. In fact, it says, where does it say? It says right on here, it's reusable and will remove approximately a half pound of rust per gallon. Now, I definitely don't have a half pound of rust, so I think we're gonna be just fine here. Okay, so I'm gonna start by pouring one of these guys in here. Actually, I'll probably pour both of them in there. Oops. Okay, let's see here. Come on. Let's see. Need a knife or something to peel this label off. Okay, I need a knife. Luckily, I'm in the kitchen. Okay. And this stuff isn't supposed to be harmful to your hands or anything like that. It only eats the rust, and it's even biodegradable. So you can pour this stuff down a toilet, down a sink, and it's not gonna harm anything, at least according to the label. Okay. Right, there's 1 gallon. I need to break open the label on this other one too. Or the seal, I should say. It's not really a label. Okay. All right. Now let's get our parts. I think I'm gonna put the rustier of the sides down first. I don't think it really matters, but okay, let's just do this. Yeah, it's right around half, actually. Let's see here. Something like that. This is going to be pretty tight. All right. Let's see if I can squeeze this in there. Oof, just barely. You know what? I may have to do one part first, because there's these stupid little plastic pieces that are raised, and I'm not able to really submerge these parts. I'm gonna have to play Tetris here a little bit. Do that. that. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do a couple rounds of this, it looks like. I don't think... I thought I could get away with doing all three of these parts, but it looks like I'm only gonna be able to get two of them. And that's okay. It'll just take more time. So, I'm gonna give this... Oh... Yeah, I think I'm gonna stick with 4 hours, and then I can flip it before... before overnight. So I think that's where I'm gonna stop and flip them over once, do this set of parts, and then I've got a couple. I'm gonna do those coin chutes too because they're really oxidized, and I think this stuff works really well on oxidized metal. So yeah, I guess I'm gonna stop there and come back when I am all finished. We'll see the results. Okay, we are back. It's actually been a couple days since I put everything into that tub, but the metal rescue needed more time to work, and it ended up being, I don't know, 8 to 12 hours, I suppose, on average per part or side that I was soaking in that stuff, but it was well worth it. I gotta say, it's a complete success, and I'm really impressed. I don't know if you can see this, let me focus here, but basically that stuff removed every piece of rust that was on these pieces, these legs, and it's not perfect. It does leave, I mean, the rust eats into the metal if it's severe enough, and so although it takes all the rust away, there's still going to be some little specks and marks from where the rust was, but it took all of the rust away and left everything else. And I am super impressed with that stuff. It's like magic. You pull the piece out and you know, the liquid gets a little bit darker from the rust it removes. But once you wash it off, it's just like, it's magic. It's just all gone. All the rust is gone. But like I said, it's not perfect. If, let me grab another piece here. If you look here, let's see. There we go. On the bottom side of this this piece here, all these little specks are damaged from the rust. So although the rust is gone, you can still see the remains there. But you know, this is the bottom side. If you look on every other side, you know, you can't see anything. It is just perfect. So I'm really happy with the results. So what I want to do now is basically any piece of metal, any of these parts that I just got done removing the rust, that I'm gonna see. So anything that's gonna be on the exterior, like the legs, I soaked these in the metal rescue too. These are the coin slots, or the bezels for the coin slots. These are metal too. Basically anything that I can see that's gonna be on the exterior, I wanna polish so that it looks nice and shiny. You know, everything's clean now. It's free of rust. I've rubbed them down, scrubbed everything, cleaned it. So that they're all set, but I want to make them presentable now. And so I've got a couple options here. I've got this Brasso, which everyone talks about using as a cleaner and polish. And so this has a good reputation. It's everyone on Clav talks about Brasso. But then I also picked up this stuff. It's called Wright's Silver Cream. And this is a cleaner and a polisher as well. Now, some people have mentioned this stuff called, I think it's called Mother's Mag. And this is basically kind of an imitation of that. I picked this up at Menards, which is kind of the Midwest, you know, cheap version of Home Depot, so to speak. It's, you know, your hardware store chain. So anyways, I'm going to give this a try because apparently this is a little less severe than Brasso, and this is kind of a rub-on stuff, and so I kind of wanted to experiment and see how well this works. Although it says silver cream, you know, it lists tons of other metals, and stainless steel is one of them. So I thought I would give this a try, and I think there's more here than in this small bottle of Brasso anyways, So I think I'm going to save this. I mean, I guess I could use it if this stuff doesn't work too well, but I'm going to give this stuff a try. And basically the instructions are, there's a little sponge in here. And this stuff's kind of, it is kind of a cream. And so you're supposed to rub this stuff all over the piece that you're working on that you want to polish. And then afterwards, you're supposed to rinse it off with water and then buff it out or rub it down with a cloth. So I'm going to give this a try and we'll see what happens. Okay, here we go. Let's see here. I guess I just get a bunch of it on this sponge here. Let's see. It doesn't give any directions for a special direction or method, just rub it on, I guess. Okay, get a little more here. And this is a first for me, so I don't know if there's really a right or a wrong way to do this, but the directions are fairly simple according to the container. But I'm sure you guys will comment or correct me if I'm doing something wrong here. Yeah, you know, some people would take this stuff in to a professional shop and have them re-chrome it. But, you know, that the last I checked, that was like, you know, you can spend $100, $200 depending on where you go. And I mean, at this point in the game, is that really worth it? If you're, you know, putting a few $100 into this thing already? Granted, I'm going to have it powder coated, but you know, when it comes to these legs, I'm not really going to be staring at them a whole lot. You know, I want them to look shiny, look presentable, but at the end of the day, I could care less really, because no one's going to be staring at this. They're going to be staring at the top covers and the areas by where the controls are. So I basically just want to get these where they can look presentable and call it good. You know, this isn't going to be the number one restore. You know, you don't have to break the bank to make stuff look nice. It just takes some elbow grease. And I actually threw a lot more parts into that metal rescue after this stuff. I put obviously the coin bezels in there. I also took all the coin mech parts, actually, like stuff like this. Oops. These are the coin chutes, and these are really, really oxidized. And I just wanted to see if that metal rescue would help, and it did. Like basically, this whole piece inside here, this whole plate was really oxidized and really rough, and it took that all off. This is all smooth. All these pieces are very smooth. I did the same thing with these guys here. So that stuff really does a lot of cleaning and removes everything. Not just rust, but you know, the oxidized stuff. So I was pretty happy with that. But again, I'm not going to be polishing those parts because I'm not going to see them. I just want to get them nice and clean and protect them from getting rusty. But other than that, no one's going to see them. So, all right. I don't know how much more I really need to do. Oh, I didn't get this side. It's kind of hard to tell if this stuff's really working or not. I suppose I won't really know until after I rinse it. And it doesn't give me, you know, let it sit for X amount of time. It just says to rinse it and use a dry cloth. All right. I don't know if it really if I really need to polish the bottom here, but what the heck? All right. I'd call this good. Okay, I'm gonna stop there. Go rinse this off and come back and then use a dry cloth to wipe it down. Be right back. Okay, so I just rinse this thing off. And now I'm gonna take just a cloth here and rub it down and kinda make sure everything's dried off and more or less rub the metal down. So, see how it goes here. And again, I'm not really sure what the results are supposed to be, how shiny this is supposed to be, but it does look pretty good. And I think, you know, another reason to polish this stuff is just to prevent future rust. You know, you could paint it or clear coat it, but this polish does double as a sealer or sealant. I don't know what the proper term is. I actually got some missed a spot here. Rinsing, a little bit of the polish went right down here, so I'll have to fix that. Kind of checking my work here. Helps to look at this from different angles, especially with the light. But I'd say it looks pretty good. I'm just trying to find a comparison here. See a little bit more here. Yeah, I'd say I'm pretty happy with that. I'm not sure it's really that much more shiny, but it definitely looks clean and presentable. And that's kind of what I'm going for. So, all right, let's move on to the next piece here. I'll speed up these other two now that we've done one together. Actually, I should get that. Okay, let's do the others. Okay, I just finished the last piece, and I have to say I'm actually pretty happy with the results. At first, I couldn't really notice, and it might just be the light, but I couldn't really notice if this stuff was really doing a polishing job. But when I sat down and looking at some before pictures I took, this stuff actually did work really well, and there's a noticeable shine to them. It did also clean up some of the spots that I didn't even know were dirty at the time, but it did take some of the spots off. But you know, this stuff really isn't 100% perfect, obviously. There's still signs from where rust used to be, but it's a night and day difference from what I started out with, and I'm really happy with that. I was going to polish all of the coin bezels, but the more I looked at them, the more I realized that they really don't need it. They're pretty shiny, and they look pretty good. There's really no reason to do that extra work for results I'm not sure I'm really going to see. And this is kind of, it's different than the chrome plating on these legs. It's more of a kind of a textured, I don't know how to describe it, but it's kind of like a mild hammered look. And it looks really good under light. So I think I'm going to leave those. I cleaned them pretty hard, and they look pretty good. So I think I'm just going to let those be. So done with the legs. The next thing I want to do, some more cleaning. Surprise, surprise. But I want to go, these are the, show you here. Oops. So these guys, there, are the coin plates, if you will. They sit one per top cover, and they basically are for the coin slots and the coin chutes. And these guys could use a good cleaning. Not terribly bad on the front. Obviously, where the bezels sit has a lot of dirt and gunk, but the backs on these are just kind of gross. There's remains of paint, red paint, lots of kind of grease and grime. So I'm just gonna clean these. And other than that, I don't think there's really much other cleaning to do. Like I said, these coin chutes are clean, and these are gonna be internal. So there's really no need to polish these guys because no one's gonna see them. But I did wanna give them a good cleaning, and pretty happy with those. Same with all the other coin parts. So I think this will be the last thing we do in this video, and then we'll go from there. So I'm gonna set up my desk here. This actually is an office desk because obviously I don't have a workbench being in an apartment, but you know, you make do with what you've got. So I'm just gonna set up for these, and I think that'll be the last thing we do in this video. Okay, so let's get started and clean these plates. I'm just going to put one off to the side here. And I'm actually going to start on the back side that's a bit more dirty. This is kind of going to be my test surface, because what I want to do is I'm going to use some grease lightning like I did before, but I want to use some steel wool. And I've heard that this works great on these plates. But I'm a little concerned that maybe this isn't a fine enough material and might leave scratches. So I thought I would just start on the back, and this can kind of be my test. Because, you know, if I scratch this, you know, nothing lost because you don't see the backside. And depending on how this turns out, I may change it up. Or if it turns out great, then I'll do the same thing on the front here. But I just want to start with the back. So first thing I'm going to do is put a little grease lightning actually on paper towel, and this way I can kind of control how much I throw on here, because if I just pour some on here, it could get all over the place. So I'm just going to use this, just kind of cover the whole thing, and it's already pulling some of the dirt off, but I just want to get everything damp here. That's pretty good. Now I'm going to go over it with the steel wool, and I'm actually going to unravel this a little bit here. Maybe double it over once. Let's see here. Just gonna go in one direction. It seems to be taking off most of the dirt and the grime. I think I need actually some more grease lightning. I don't know if you can hear that. I've got the window cracked open, but it is really windy outside. And you know, I think it's November 10th, and we just had our first snow for the year. And I guess that's Minnesota for you. All right. Oof. This is looking pretty good. I still got some old paint and dirt on the corners here. I might actually try one of these Scotch-Brite pads. Boy, there is some hard paint on here. I'm not sure this is really going to come off entirely. Yeah, that is not coming off. And it is really crusty. I may just end up leaving this. You know, it's really no big deal. This is going on the back. But other than that, it really got most of the dirt off. Let's see here. I'm just gonna wipe this down here. I just want to basically inspect this, see if the steel wool left any scratches. And I'm not really seeing any signs of it, so I think it's pretty safe to use on the front here. And I mean really the only spot I'm concerned with is around these bezels. This is where most of the dirt is, and I'm probably gonna try to avoid this Nintendo logo, because the worst thing that could possibly happen would be that this steel wool would take some of that paint off. So okay, let's get some grease lightning here. Oop, got a little excessive. Again, I'm just dampening this whole plate with the cleaner. And this stuff isn't heavy duty enough where it's gonna really take off that paint, so. All right. Oh yeah, this is working well. And there's actually, if you look real closely, there's fine lines that go horizontally, so that's why I'm going this way with the steel wool, just to play it safe. And yeah, this seems to be working pretty well. Oh yeah, need a little bit more grease lightning in here. That's looking pretty good. I think this one's pretty well set. I'm just gonna wipe it down with a dry cloth here. You know, I think I'm going to polish this too, since This is going to be right on the front. So I've got this, the right silver cream like we used before. Actually, let me close that window here. That wind is really howling. Okay. Grab my sponge here. This stuff gets all over my fingers. The nice thing that I found with this silver cream, in hindsight, is that it's a little more mild than, say, like Brasso. And it's nice because it still provides a nice shine, but it's a little less severe. So if you, you know, have something like this that maybe has some paint, you don't have to really worry as much about it taking it off. So it's kind of a, it's kind of a safe polish, if you will. This is pretty good here. All right, I'll rinse these off together. For now, I'm just gonna set it up here. Okay, let's get to the other one. Okay, I just rinsed these plates off. Now I'm gonna go with a towel here and just rub them down and kind of make sure everything's wiped off and kind of buff them. And this is looking pretty good. It's definitely polished. I don't know how I didn't notice before the difference, but it is very evident now. Get the back here. Oh yeah, this stuff works great. I think it all comes down to lighting. I may have been looking at it from the wrong angle. Of course, it's always easier when you have a before and after comparison. Oh yeah. This looks pretty pleased with this. So, all right, let's get the other one. Thank goodness these didn't have any rust on them. I think I would have been a little concerned throwing these into that metal rescue. I don't know if that would pull paint off of this stuff or not. It's only supposed to attack rust. And so I don't think it would, but I would still be a little concerned. Nothing's uglier than rust, though. I mean, as soon as that stuff was gone, it made those legs look 10 times better. Yeah, this looks pretty good. Yeah, I think, all right, well, I think that concludes this video. I think I'm going to stop there. Okay, actually, before I end this video, I just wanted to show you something. I just pulled these metal brackets out of my tub with the metal rescue. These were the last thing that I was soaking in there. And these mount behind the top cover by the monitor to hold the glass and the tinted glass and the bezel in place. But these were absolutely caked with rust. And let me just focus here so you can see this. These were some of the rustiest parts I had. And I did take some before pictures that I'll throw up here. But that stuff is freaking amazing. It basically, this whole line here, all the way around the edge, was just caked with rust. And that metal rescue completely removed it. I've already wiped this one down, but I need to wipe this one. But that stuff is freaking amazing. I am so sold on it. These turned out great. I actually have four of them, and two were pretty decent, but these two were really rusted. So anyways, I'm just going to rub this last one down here. But that stuff is just amazing. I don't know. I am just so sold on it. You know, it's not cheap. It's, I don't know. I think it's $20 for a gallon. Or, let's see. $20. But you can reuse that stuff just about until the water. Well, I use this on every part that I've got, just about every metal part. And by the time I was done, at least after these two brackets, that liquid was basically black. And they say that you can just reuse that stuff until it loses its effectiveness, or the water is completely dark like that. And up to the very end, it worked pretty well. I think I soaked these for, what was it? Maybe like 8 hours. And it did a phenomenal job. Oh yeah. I'm just using some steel wool here. It kind of gets the last of the grime. That liquid kind of leaves a little residue, and so you do need to wipe it down after you pull it out. But yeah, I'm pretty darn happy with this. And again, this is something that no one's going to see, because it actually sits inside the top cover on the inside. But I just want to make sure everything's clean and there's no residue left over. That's looking pretty good. Let me see here. There. So, yeah, it turned out really nice. Well, I think I'm going to end the video here. Since this kind of concludes all the cleaning that I wanted to do. And in the next video, I think I'm going to address and hopefully tackle all of the major dings and dents in the metal frame, the top covers, the control panel upper cover. So basically all the noticeable dings and dents that are in the metal, I want to try to address those and hopefully flatten those out so that it's presentable and ready to be sandblasted and powder coated. So anyways, hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for listening to me ramble on here. And yeah, I'll see you for part 4. Thanks, guys.